over the years, there have been many times when people have taken a stand for what they believe. This was one of those times. The people of Jerusalem had already had a long history of captivity, beginning in 587 BC. The Babylonians captured the Jews, beginning the Babylonian exile. But in 538 BC, Cyrus the Great conquers Babylon, setting the Jews free. After being taken over by the Seleucids, in 167 BCE, the Maccabees revolt. And finally, in 6 CE, Rome conquers Judea. Now that Jerusalem had been conquered by Rome, the Romans needed to find a person worthy of ruling over the Jews. Herod the Great was born a Jew, but supported Rome his whole life. Once Jerusalem became controlled by Rome, Julius Caesar appointed Herod king of the Jews. From here on, he was known as a tyrant and killed anyone who could become king. For this reason, he built a fortress on plateau, just in case there was a revolt by the civilians.
Want a chocolate? Under Roman rule, there were many ethnic tensions. The Jews did not like the taxes the Romans had put on them, so they protested. This made the Romans very angry. The Jews were supposed to be listening to them. To teach the Jews a lesson, the Romans plundered and destroyed the Jewish temple. Mama told me that means they stole all their stuff. This scared the Jews, so they fled and hid on top of Masada at the fortress King Herod had built.
The fortress on top of Masada would have been the ideal place to hold out against an empire. There is only one way to the top, and only one person can fit through it once. Although located in the center of a desert and miles away from a source of water, Herod had already found out a solution for hydration. Herod's solution was aqueducts. Herod built 12 cisterns that could hold 40,000 cubic meters of water and were capable of feeding 1,000 people for 10 years. The one-person pathway leading to the top of Masada was known as the snake. This is because it curves around just like the body of a snake. Because of Masada's geography, the Jews were able to hold off the massive Roman army for a very long time. Months into the battle, the Romans had an idea. They would build a siege ramp on the western side of Masada to surprise the Jews and hopefully penetrate their fortress. But by the time the Romans could break through, the fortress had been set aflame and all but 7 of the rebels had committed suicide. See you there. In conclusion, Masada is historically significant because instead of surrendering to the massive Roman army, the Jewish people took a stand and fought to the death and are now a symbol of Jewish heroics and made an international name for Jerusalem. Masada is still benefiting Israel today because it is the second most visited tourist site in Jerusalem. I'm Tyler Thomas. Thank you for watching.
chained our hearts in vain. We jumped, never asking why. We kissed, I fell under your spell of love no one could deny. Don't you ever say I just walked away. I will always want you. I can't live a lie, running for my life. I will always want you. I came in like a wrecking ball. I never hit so hard in love. All I wanted was to break your walls. All you ever did was...
You're still here? It's over. Go home. Go.